was the Australian dollar. Did anyone watch the discussion room video I put in the discussion room today?
Nothing I did, no.
No? Oh, I didn't. So in that video, I pretty much just went over a trade that was posted yesterday, and a trade that I'm currently in at the moment, and it's pretty much exactly the same thing. So if we were looking at this from a daily, I'll go into the daily time frame. So on, I think it was Monday where we had the I think it was Mark that had asked about this, the analysis on this. So Monday prices came up into here, and then we saw an outside candle. Yeah, which one on the 4 hour? I think there's one on the 3 hour. I was looking at the 3 hour, but it didn't matter anyway. Regardless, they both closed at the same time. So the entry was here, yeah, on that candlestick, and then there was another entry on the 50% retracement pending order. And by the way, the pending order should only really last for about a week. Yeah, anything longer than that, I wouldn't do it. If you know what I mean, or if price actually gets to maybe a two, let's say for example you're in this one position and price hasn't pulled back, and then prices get to like a 2-to-1, let's say, then just cancel the order. I think after that you just want to run that one position. But if prices haven't got to your profit target, or where you want to potentially take some sort of partial profits, and it's been under a week, then keep the pending order there. So pretty much enter two positions, one there, one there, there, and then the stop loss was 10 pips above the highs, so it was 17, so 27, it's about here, 28, and then obviously entering into a second position on the pending order there, and then again the stop loss was at 27. You know, prices came back, pinged in the second position. Prices have now gone for a nice 2-to-1. So I'm fully out of this position now. So now I'm up. So now this first position, this one position, and if I'm right about this, about risk off overall from a daily perspective, the potential downside I now have for this trade is really nice, because at the absolute maximum, I can probably look to squeeze out maybe like a 22-to-1 if you're right about it. So once we're in this trade, how I would manage it is this. Obviously, I would just keep holding, and then let's say for example Bloomberg really starts to talk about negative sentiment. Yeah, there's lots of, you know, oil starts to look to collapse. There's risk. You know, central banks are, you know, printing money, da 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 da. Like, I'm looking for just negative news, yeah, to potentially look to hold this trade, a negative sentiment overall. Would I get this right? Would I get this wrong? Who knows? But the key is that I'm already up on this trade, so now I can just, you know, decide to maybe run it down to here if I want to run it down to there, wherever. But potentially now, look at the risk reward on that. And all you got to do is be right on, you know, a few of these trades a year. That's it. You know, three, four, five of these trades a year, and this is where your account is going to grow.
So if what I'm saying resonates with you, why not check out trading180.com? There is a selection process to trade my supply and demand zone Forex strategy. I'm only looking to work with individuals with the right mindset, you know, who are hardworking as well. So check that out. And access really for less than £1 a day. Some of the strategies in here are not for beginners. So if you don't know what supply and demand is, please check out all of my supply and demand videos. I have hundreds of videos on YouTube, so you can check that out first. Guys, take care, and until the next video, have a good one.